855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. Whether you want to talk about silly presidential candidates or the awful presidential candidates, you can certainly do so here. It's open phones all the time. With you in studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got the news about the dismal rankings of the United States compared to other countries around the world. We can talk about that as well. Once again, 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
If you've got a business of your own, you know how frustrating IT can be. It doesn't have to be, though. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. RootWork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability, keeping your customers happy and your staff productive. RootWork can make IT meet your needs, and to prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with one of their senior consultants for free to answer any of your IT questions. So they're going to give you solutions to your IT problem right over the phone for free. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL. That's FTL as in Free Talk Live. And that'll get you your free call. It's rootwork.it/FTL. Root is spelled R-O-O-T, work.it/FTL.
All right, so let's go to the phones and to the fun. We've got Kevin listening in Wyoming. Kevin, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, I'm on a high 90. Hey, I got a question. There's a program called Waters World that's on Fox News, and I'd like to see Waters go out and talk to a bunch of sixth graders and see what they understand about wiping files or deleting files. I was shocked by Hillary Clinton's statement the other day when Ed Henry asked the question about wiping files. She said, "What do you mean wiping? Like wiping with a cloth or something stupid? That is demeaning to every U.S. citizen."
Yeah, wiping the computer, I believe, is what the statement was more similar to that.
So is the idea she didn't know, was she feigning that she didn't know what wiping files meant?
That's correct. Yeah, and I'd like to see what sixth graders like to think about that. I think it'd be very, very interesting.
All right. Well, I can't help you with that, but yeah, that would be very interesting, I suppose. It is always interesting to find out the engagement level of young people in America, and I imagine they would be well aware of what wiping files are at age 10.
I can't imagine.
I think so.
It's hard to predict the future and presidential campaigns. I mean, I'm thinking back to 2012, where we had this every 3 weeks there was a new front runner. So it's difficult to know today what's going to happen in a few months. But it really seems difficult to me to imagine that somebody who's had so many scandals. I mean, it just goes back more than a decade worth of scandals, and I don't care that much about most of them. It just seems that they're so public that during a general, that's going to get brought up over and over again.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm ex-military, and I used to have a TS clearance. And what she did was absolutely wrong, and it's not going to go away.
Thanks, Kevin, for your call tonight. Appreciate it. Let's talk to Chris in South Carolina. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. By the way, where are you calling from in South Carolina?
Me? I'm calling between Myrtle Beach and Florence. I'm a musician on my way to do a job.
Excellent, sir. I imagine you're listening to WRNN. So go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I hear for the last many years about the Republican Party's always saying the only way to get the country going again is the private sector. Well, here we got a private sector guy, Donald Trump, trying to get in to run for president, and all the party's doing is bashing him. Now, there's a guy that's got new ideals, new ways, and all this. And
what are his new ideas? I don't know. I don't pay any attention to these presidential candidates.
Well, I mean, one of his ideals is that he has hired many people. He's done a lot of trade. That's where he is right now. That's all I do know about Donald Trump.
How's that a new idea, the fact that he's hired people?
Well, I mean, what I've heard on the radio and from him, because I'm mostly on the road, I haven't really sat down and listened to a lot of, who they are, what they are, but what I have heard over the years is that, the only way this country is going to get going back in jobs is the private sector. Well, he is a private sector guy. I don't see all these career guys who've been in the office in Washington for many years they all got ideals, but nobody's putting the ideals to work.
I think you can I think I can agree that you can give Trump that credit, right? Like, he is somebody who's a success in his own right, whether you agree with all the things he does or not.
Some people would say four bankruptcies it, you know, means he's not a success in business.
Well, sometimes you have to fail your way to success in life, Mark. And
Romney can claim a much better track record in business than Trump could,
Let's put it this way. He got up there and he says he got away with all his tax things that he done because that's the way of the law. Okay? Now, someone has got all that kind of money, and then there's other people got money going offshores. Why isn't that money being taxed? Even like, okay, you go to any Food Lion around here or Lowe's on a Friday, that's a grocery store.
They still have Food Lion? I thought they closed that brand down in the late 90s.
No, well, listen. You go there on a Friday night, all this money, they got lines of people sending money over to Mexico, okay? Why don't they tax that money going over there? Because here's why they won't.
How about we just don't tax anybody? How about no more taxes at all? Instead of
I agree with that.
Instead of begging the
government
to tax people who are smart enough to try to avoid those taxes, how about we congratulate those people?
They congratulate them. They come over here, okay, illegal, okay? They're not coming over the way my grandfather did, okay, or my great-grandfather did from Ireland. Okay.
What, were you there?
If your grandfather came from Ireland, there's a good chance they came illegally.
Well, they come here on a boat through New York City.
Some did, some didn't.
Through New York City.
Boston's full of Irish for a reason.
Well, listen, man, I'm not here to argue. I'm just trying to get a point out.
Oh, but that's what talk radio is all about, is conflict.
Listen.
Yeah.
Last year's all you've been hearing is that the Republican Party saying the only way to get this country back going is the private sector. They have a private sector guy running for president who doesn't need nobody's money. He doesn't need anybody underneath his belt saying, "Hey, I'm going to donate all this money."
Yeah, he certainly. I'll give you that one too, Chris. Thanks for the call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. Drive safe tonight. I'll give him that one too. Like, you know, Trump has the intellectual honesty to. You know, not run in lockstep with all of the other Republican candidates. He's the only guy who refused to endorse whoever the eventual nominee is. And he deserves, I think, a fair amount of credit for being willing to take that kind of independent stand on stage. I mean, to me, he's just another politician. He's more entertaining than the average politician. I'll give him that. But I certainly don't agree with a lot of things he's talking about.
Okay, so there are other private sector people in there. Dr. Carson is in, as is Dr. Rand Paul. They're both private sector
guys.
There's
that HP lady, right?
Yep, Carly Fiorina.
And now look, the thing is with these private sector people, this has been tried so many different times where somebody comes along and they ran a company, and so they say things like, "Well, you should elect me because I ran the most successful computer corporation in the world for X amount of years. I'll bring my business expertise to the Oval Office. We'll make government run like a business." When has that ever been the case?
Government can't run like a business. It doesn't have the same market mechanisms.
But Mark, what if someone who knows how to run a business gets into the government? Couldn't they force the government to run like a business?
Only if they made it so the government did not claim a monopoly privilege over the given land mass.
None of them are planning to do that.
No, they're not. They intend to run the government like a monopoly, and it will run like a monopoly as it has for thousands of years.
Join us at 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com. unveilingthem.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Okay, honey, I have to ask, and be honest here. Have you been taking a little blue pill? Because things have been pretty good in the bedroom lately.
No, I swear.
You didn't pick anything up at the Pharmacia last month in Cancun?
No.
Well, something's different.
I have been taking that heart and body extract you bought me.
But that's for your heart and to control your cholesterol.
Well, I read HB extract also promotes healthy prostate function.
I never guessed it would work this well, but...
You're glad it did.
Oh, yeah.
Heart and Body Extract is a 100% organic formula that promotes a strong heart, healthy arterial flow, better circulation, improves erectile and prostate gland function, and provides youthful energy, strength, and stamina. Find out more at heartandbodyextract.com. Heart and Body Extract, paired with healthy heart choices, is a winning combination. Call toll-free to order or for free information. 1-866-295-5305. 1-866-295-5305.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MYTV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, you may dial toll-free to join us here on the live Saturday edition of this program. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And here is how, very simply, you can save 20, 25%, maybe even more on whatever you want to buy from Amazon. Almost everything at Amazon you can get through saveatpurse.com. And when you go to saveatpurse.com, you can get registered. Basically, what's happening is you create an account and we get a very small credit for anything that you buy from that point forward. There's another URL that you can go to after that. But for right now, just go to saveatpurse.com, get signed up through that link, and then go and get some Bitcoin if you don't yet have any, because that's the key to this. That's how you get this huge discount off the already amazing prices and selection of products over at Amazon. So if you've shopped at Amazon before, you know how great of an experience it can be. Now imagine saving 20% on everything that you buy there, because it's possible.
Just Amazon has just about everything you need for life. It's, you know, just about everything you need.
Saveatpurse.com. Go get signed up, and we'll tell you later how to get your hands on some Bitcoin. Price is down on the Bitcoin, by the way. Might be a good time to buy some of it. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Let's go right back to your phone calls and thoughts. We'll go first to Bob, listening in Ohio via TuneIn on his apps. Go ahead, Bob.
Hey, guys. How's it going tonight?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Hey. I just had a thought about how America is losing its freedom and how it's not as free as it was, say, 20 years ago.
Sure.
I think some of the fault could be us as a society basically just whining and moaning about everything. One example is here in Ohio. They used to do a lot of decorations at the State House, at the City Hall, a lot of Christmas decorations. And people were just whining and moaning about it because they say it's too religious, it points too far to Christianity. So they gave in and said, okay, well, we won't do it anymore. No more nativity scenes, no more Christmas trees.
And now people whine and moan about that. Right? Like, that's really the difficulty here is that I agree with you, but I think that people whine and moan all over the planet. Is that the people that call it whining and moaning are the ones that, don't want to change. And then once it gets changed, then those people whine and moan. So there's always somebody who's going to whine and moan.
That's a good point.
I don't know if people whining necessarily has to do with the loss of freedom. It could certainly be that people are apathetic and don't believe they can beat City Hall. So when the government guys continue to destroy freedom by passing more laws and regulations and taxes, then people just sit back and take it. And they whine about it, but they don't actually do anything about it. What do you think?
Right. That is a good point. I mean, it was kind of my idea of the day, but it's just, and we're also electing leaders that, you know, anytime people start to whine and moan, well, they give in and start writing policies, like taking away our right to buy soda over 16 ounces and having...
That didn't actually happen, right? Didn't that get stopped in New York City, the soda restrictions?
I thought it went through.
Well, it went through, then it got taken away.
Yeah, it got challenged.
But the fact that it went through the fact that it went through in the first place was just...
No doubt. That's certainly an indicator that anybody who cares about freedom should not be in a place like New York. I mean, that place is just getting worse and worse, literally, as each day goes by. Bob, thanks for calling
down,
sharing your thoughts here tonight. Actually, I've heard there was an uptick, Mark. I don't know if that's true or not, but I mean, you're saying crime's down over time, over a few decades, but I thought I heard recently that it...
Crime's down
up.
In comparison to New York. Mm-hmm. Crime in New York compared to Vermont, Maine, or New Hampshire stinks.
Very high. So,
yeah. You know.
So let's continue with your calls and thoughts. By the way, I did see here that Food Lion still does exist. Our last caller had mentioned Food Lion, and I thought they had changed branding way back in the late 1990s after the situation with the alleged expired meat. Turns out there was a big court case about that I wasn't aware of. It was ABC News that was investigating Food Lion back
then. Were you in high school in the 90s?
Yeah. I'd heard about the story, though, Mark. Yeah. Do you remember hearing about it?
Yeah, sure.
Then? So apparently what was happening was ABC's undercover employees were supposedly witness to these alleged unsanitary practices, but the company sued ABC for fraud, claiming ABC's employees misrepresented themselves, trespassed, and because they came onto Food Lion property without permission and for breach of loyalty, the ABC employees videotaped non-public areas of the store and revealed internal company information. During the court battles between Food Lion and ABC, over 40 hours of unused footage were released that helped Food Lion's case. In the unused footage, two undercover producers are seen trying to encourage violations of company policy.
Mm.
However, employees resisted and correctly followed sanitary practices. So this sounds like some unscrupulous journalism.
Well, a lot of these ag gag bills that are in place now, this is essentially what the claim is going on with many of the animal rights activists looking into factory farms and these sorts of things that they... only show sort of cut scenes, the very worst of stuff, things like that.
Let's go on. Marvin is with us in New Jersey. Marvin, you're listening to WVNJ.
Yeah, I wanted to talk about Hillary with this thing about the server and wiping it clean.
Yeah, tell me about it.
The information not being available. But I thought, who was Snowden? What's his name? Is his name Eric or Edward?
Edward Snowden.
No, Snowden. We found out through him that the NSA captures all of that stuff online.
Yep.
So I don't know why there's an issue that it's not being available. They have it.
That's an interesting point, and I suspect that
I'm going to hang up and listen to
Thank
the radio.
You, Marvin, for the call tonight. Thanks for listening there in very near to New York, WVNG, VNJ, great station.
Well, it's not that I disagree with Marvin's sort of overarching point. I think the claim is that Hillary Clinton's at-home server was not as secure as the NSA's captured data. So the idea is that what she was doing was exposing national security risks, and she could only do it because she's her, and that is an indication sort of how she, the claim is how she runs, runs her business, how she runs her life, and how she was going to run the nation in the future is a sort of, there's all these great rules, but none of them apply to me.
But, okay, so I got to say, I haven't been following this story very close. So what you're saying is Hillary was putting national security at risk by running her own email server, basically.
I think that the impression I got is basically she had a computer at home and had her stuff that was secure sent there.
But not in a secure fashion,
right,
is the idea. And this guy, though, was saying that, why can't they find these emails if the NSA has them? Why don't they just hand them over? I think he was kind of making a different point entirely.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Okay, so if they're investigating her and the idea is that, well, now these emails have been wiped, is that right?
I've heard is that I think wiping the machine was supposed to be a good thing because that way it's, safe. I don't know.
So now, if the caller's point was if the NSA has been gobbling up all of the emails in the world, then why shouldn't they
be a problem getting some evidence?
Right. Just tap into them, give them a call and have them dial it up.
Well, that's the FBI is doing whatever investigations behind this, not the NSA. And government agencies are notorious for working poorly together.
Yeah, that much is certainly true, and you could certainly argue that the NSA is interested in protecting the politicians rather than
the politicians that the NSA is interested in protecting, at least.
Right.
Remember,
for the moment, the
NSA has access to all the politicians' emails, and this is what scares me the most about the NSA grabbing this information is hey, wait, look, they're grabbing all the information from the politicians. As soon as they find out if they've got a mistress or if they've taken a payoff or the wrong campaign contributions or whatever, that politician is in the pocket of the whatever NSA agent wished to be unscrupulous.
Boy, speaking of mistresses, how about that Ashley Madison hack where gigabytes of data are now available for anyone who wants to spend the time to download and who has the technical expertise to parse through it, to look through this? Friend of the show, technical wizard Steve here in town, was checking it out last night, and he found some interesting information. There's the emails that are in the database, but those aren't very valuable because they never checked the email addresses when people would sign up. They wouldn't verify them. But there are credit card transactions listed, and those would be much more reliable to be the person who's actually putting it through. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. But once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. We will, of course, take your calls about anything you want to discuss. You can get us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. You can also call toll-free to 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And King Mark.
Don't forget, you can also enjoy the website. Lots of archives going back for not quite an entire decade, but a whole lot of free MP3 files. You just go and download as many as you like and get interactive in a variety of ways. We've got a chat room. There's a webcam and more. Go to freetalklive.com. And enjoy as we go to your phone calls and thoughts. Steve in Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hello, Steve.
How you doing tonight?
Welcome, sir. You're on the radio.
Yeah, like I got a couple interesting tidbits about the immigration situation.
Oh?
I just want the bleeding hearts and the liberals to listen real good. In Los Angeles County, just in Los Angeles County and L.A., it costs $500 million just to get the illegal immigration settled in good.
What's that mean? Illegal immigration settled in good?
You mean like help them find a house?
That means the payments and everything else, hospitals, schools, everything, mm-hmm. all that added up, $500 million just in L.A. County.
I wonder what that is as far as a percentage of the budget, because L.A. is a pretty big place. I mean, it's bigger than...
Oh, L.A. is broke. I mean, the whole California is broke, isn't it?
It was at some point. I don't know what's going on now, but it was a couple of years ago.
Dean Brown running it now?
Yep. You know, I wonder to myself...
$26.9 billion for the county budget, not for the city. That's for L.A. County.
One thing's for sure is anybody who wants to see people have more freedom around crossing borders in the world, it has to take into consideration that people are not prepared, not interested in paying extra money for sort of welfare services and, you know, whatever services might go to people who come across the borders.
But that's what you forgot. Hey, I just want to just mention, that's what you forgot to mention about that Irish guy whose grandparents came across. There was no security blanket for those people when they came across.
It's really important. It's absolutely important. If they could create, say, a new government, a new situation, instead of, say, a green card, maybe they create a blue card where people, you know, they open up a great deal more immigration because immigrants are good for the economy. But this blue card has no government services at all. You get no government services. The only thing you get to do is come here, work for a better life. And maybe they focus on certain cities like Detroit or New Orleans or Memphis, these ones that have these blighted houses and that sort of thing. Let folks go and take them over and receive no government services.
How about the third of the prison population now is illegal immigration?
I don't believe that for a second. I don't believe that's for a second. The American Conservative Magazine did a study. Just
did you ever see the prison magazine with all the gangs in there? Latino gangs?
I've been in prison, so I have a reasonable idea of what it's like in there.
Mark spent 8 years in prison.
And I can tell you
that... probably wasn't down no top security prison.
I was in a level three institution in the state of Florida. That's the lowest level of maximum. So there's three levels of maximum, the highest being death row, the lowest being a level three, and then there's a level four, higher containment. So... I've been at several different levels of institutions, and I can tell you the amount of illegal immigrants that were there was... not negligible, but not nearly a third.
Steve, would you agree that we ought to shut down all government welfare and just allow charities to handle helping people?
Well, that's how it was back before, right?
Yeah, like mutual aid and charities. Yeah, sure. So would you be in favor of that?
I suggest you cut down all the benefits to them and they would go back to their own country.
No. I meant to everybody, like getting rid of government welfare entirely.
Well, there's some people that's going to need welfare, whether we like it or not.
Oh, so you're okay with
this? That position doesn't make any sense. Wait a minute now.
They got no legs and arms. You got to get somebody to take care of you.
I got you. How come you don't care about the people with no legs and no arms that are in Chihuahua, but you do care about the people with no legs and no arms that are in North Carolina?
Oh, well, let Chihuahua take care of them.
Chihuahua isn't doing very well, sir. I mean, you know, what North Carolina is going to do is take money from rich people and give it to people with no arms and no legs.
We're not doing very well either, buddy. Have you checked it lately? $18 trillion.
I do not support having the government taking care of people, whether it's in
wherever.
I'm pointing inconsistencies out.
Wait, I'm confused here.
Hey, when are we going to start doing good?
Steve, hang on a sec. We got to work on that for a moment. Look. As far as helping people out, what I was suggesting is we have charity do it. You weren't talking about bringing people from Chihuahua here to have government take care of
them. The point I was trying to make is that it is philosophically inconsistent to say that I have to, you know, I or anybody, some rich person, I'm not rich, that some rich person has to take care of a person with no arms and no legs. He came up with the story, I didn't, that's in North Carolina, but that same rich person doesn't have to take care of a person with no arms and no legs that's in Chihuahua, which is a state in Mexico.
Steve, what do you think about that? Are you inconsistent?
No, I'm not inconsistent. I want everybody to take care of themselves. They can, but the ones that need it the most... let the countries take care of them, and we'll take care of ours.
So you support forced wealth redistribution?
Do I support what? I didn't hear you.
You support the use of force to distribute wealth, like socialism.
No, you know I'm not a socialist.
Well, I don't know you, Steve. You just told me you support government welfare, and that's a socialist program.
I said for the people that absolutely positively need
that's
it.
That's still socialism. Why can't people?
So many healthy people on it right now that they're not. That's not
Steve.
That's
why
not
can't
a
see the
truth,
thing is it doesn't matter how many people you have in the program. It's still socialism to force people to pay for services they may or may not value. But why shouldn't people be able to just choose for themselves to help the sick people and the injured people and the poor people?
Well, I thought that's during the 20s and 30s and 40s and 50s. That's the way he did it.
Yeah, let's try that again. Thanks, Steve, for the call tonight. Dave is in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Dave. Our toll-free number, by the way, is 855-450-FREE. Go ahead, Dave.
Well, I really enjoy you guys. I feel you have a pretty good grasp of it all, and you're not easily shattered by people that scare a little bit of what the bureaucracy is all about. So
thanks. Go ahead with why you were calling.
Well, I've been trying to analyze several of these candidates that are running, and we certainly have enough of them. And I find two big exceptions, and one of them is Donald Trump. I find, as Marvin there of New York and a few of the other callers, that most of the candidates are in the business of accepting big payoffs from crooked special interests, pharmaceutical companies, insurance company, crooked banks, crooked, all kinds of things. And these are not people that are interested in seeing honest government. When they try to pay off the Democrats and try to pay off the Republicans, they're wanting something special in return.
Absolutely.
The right to be able to grab more for them and screw over some other group.
But so, you think Donald Trump's somehow different from that just because
he doesn't.
No?
Well, I think that he's not owned by the other big special interest. He is his own.
Mark, don't jump to conclusions, Mark.
I just couldn't believe it. So, well, he's probably not owned. I would believe that special interests probably believe Trump will turn on them, yes.
I don't for a minute think that Donald Trump, however, is in the business of trying to do something to benefit the citizens. I don't find that. I don't feel he's in the business of trying to do good for people in general.
He is certainly going to do good for Donald Trump. That much you can count on. Thank you for the call tonight, Dave. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
I don't think Donald Trump is running for president. I think he's running for his next television program.
Do you think he's going to go with the independent campaign if he does not get the nomination?
If it benefits Donald Trump.
All right, so you can share your thoughts here. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE.
I was at the Freedom Fest where Donald Trump spoke, and there was an incident where a bunch of police were escorting a very loud man out of the building.
Someone trying to interrupt him?
It was the police. I'll tell you, the police were escorting a very loud man who out of the building. I saw him from a distance. I assumed the loudness and the shouting was a drunk guy or something like that. Got a little closer. It was Donald Trump.
Donald Trump was escorted out of the event to which he was invited?
In an entirely different way, right? Like he actually had an escort. Do you get what I'm saying?
They were escorting him out, not because he was a bad boy, but because he was...
Because he was Donald Trump. He was being escorted out. But he was allowed. Like it was just such a weird thing.
It was his security detail.
I completely misinterpreted what I saw because of the sort of loudness.
Were they actual uniformed police or was it hotel security or Donald Trump security?
I think it was all of that. It was an entourage. There must have been, I don't want to exaggerate, but at least 8 people.
So he was a featured speaker at this event?
Yeah.
Did he take questions from people?
I don't know.
Did you watch it?
No, I left.
Oh, okay.
What the hell would I want to listen to that for?
I don't know.
Lied to enough in my life. I don't need this crap. I went to P.F. Chang's. It was great.
All right, so...
J.P. Plank Chang's, whatever
that's
it is.
P.F. Chang's. I've never been to one, but that's what it's called.
It was good.
855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. The U.S. drops on the list of most free countries in the world. We'll talk about it.
Breathe it in, kid. Every 3 months, we install these air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are priced to save us more money. And Granger's got close to 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from, in stock and ready when we need them. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/filters or stop by. Granger. For the ones who get it done.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code update to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text update to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code update to 42767 right now. That's update to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. Firefighters working with shovels building a fire line around a house in Washington State that was threatened by wildfire. Homeowner Brad Craig says he came back to his house despite an evacuation order.
I got over here in a pair of scrubs and a pair of flip-flops and found the fire 20, 30 yards from our back deck. I had a shovel and nothing else, and it was already starting to climb the trees.
The Ogonagon complex of wildfires, where three firefighters died on Wednesday, grew by more than 100 square miles and stood at 355 square miles on Saturday morning. Federal governments declared an emergency. State officials took the unprecedented step of seeking volunteers to help fight the flames. Volunteers were to begin training on Saturday. Also at SRNNews.com, potential GOP presidential nominees took to the stage at Defending the American Dream Summit in Columbus, Ohio, Saturday. Senator Marco Rubio says the U.S. has become more competitive globally.
There are dozens of other countries that learned from our example. And so now they have limited government, they have lower taxes, they have less regulations. And so every day we see American jobs and companies go abroad.
Well, Senator Ted Cruz says he'd like to shut down the IRS.
There are about 90,000 employees at the IRS. We need to padlock that building. Take all 90,000 and put them down on our southern border.
On Friday, Governor Bobby Jindal and former Governor Jeb Bush spoke to the gathering. The first high-level talks in nearly a year between South Korea and North Korea were adjourned after stretching into the early hours of Sunday as the rivals looked to defuse mounting tensions that have pushed them to the brink of possible military confrontation. It all stems over South Korea pumping music and speakers at the border. Negotiators will be back at the table later Sunday afternoon to continue their talks. This is SRN News.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360 to talk to a certified counselor.
I had heard about Trinity, so I made the call. They took care of all of my credit cards, and now I am completely debt-free.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360.
My name is Ann, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-758-5360.
The new Army Chief of Staff, General Mark Milley, is taking a calculated approach to arguably the most consequential decision of his early tenure, whether to recommend that any all-male combat roles remain closed to women.
Central to his thinking is the question of whether allowing women to serve in the infantry, armor, and other traditionally male-only fields would affect Army readiness for war. Captain Kristen Greist, who will graduate Army Ranger School, says the women's performance should send a message.
That we can handle things physically and mentally on the same level as men, and that we can deal with the same stresses and training that the men can.
Military leaders are weighing in on whether to recommend to Defense Secretary Ash Carter that he keep some positions off limits to women. Patrick Foss, SRN News.
Officials in Santa Barbara County, California, trying to determine the source of smelly oil and tar balls that have forced the closure of a popular beach just south of Santa Barbara. This is SRN News. A government survey shows most states have parking shortages for trucks, which pose a safety concern. Correspondent Lyndon Kenyon reports.
Almost half of the state transportation departments surveyed by the Federal Highway Administration said truckers are forced to park in unsafe places like freeway interchange ramps and highway shoulders and vacant lots. Officials say this poses an additional concern because truck drivers who are tired might continue to drive if they have trouble finding safe parking places to rest. The survey also found more than 75% of truck drivers reported regularly experiencing problems with finding safe parking when they needed rest. Linda Kenyon, Washington.
Mulling over a presidential bid, Vice President Joe Biden met Saturday with Elizabeth Warren, who's also facing calls to enter the 2016 race. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Free Talk Live.
So if you had to guess at what the number is that the U.S. is ranked at in the world's freedom rankings, what number out of the 180-some, 190 countries of the world
that are ranked?
That are ranked in this. What number is the United States in the most recent Fraser Institute ranking? Nope, don't look it up. You just have to guess at it. We'll tell you about it here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Ian and Mark in the studio for the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. Let's go to the phones right away. Mark, listening in Wisconsin to WXXM in Madison. Hey, Mark.
Hey. This whole political charade of the two-party presentation by most of the media is absurd when 50% of the population doesn't register or call themselves either a Democrat or a Republican.
Yeah,
that's
true.
The debates won't allow a Green Party candidate in, won't allow a Libertarian Party in. The previous caller mentioned the corruption in government and in banking. And both the Libertarian and the Green parties have a monetary policy reform plank in their thing, but the Democratic and Republican candidates are going to do nothing about monetary reform.
No doubt. They like things to status quo.
Why would they?
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
And so the problem is that the real issue about monetary reform will never make it into the electoral process, because anybody who wants to speak about eliminating the power of creating money directly from banking is never going to be allowed to speak. So the Green Party has a plan right now, or at least is trying to make the focus that 50% of the population doesn't even register as Democrat or Republican. They should be allowed in the debates.
Yeah, I think that seems so obvious. The Libertarians and the Greens, I remember back in 2004, was, I don't know if you recall this, but the Libertarian and Green presidential candidates were actually arrested when they attempted to get into, just to attend, not to, you know, go on stage, but to actually physically attend one of the debates. You remember that one?
Yeah, they were both arrested.
Yeah, pretty crazy. That shows you how far they'll go to protect these debates from any semblance of fairness. They do not want competition on that stage.
Perot scared the pants off of them.
In 92.
In 92, and I just don't think that it, you know, it's the two-party duopoly really showed its hand at that point.
Yeah, well, so I think then that it's the responsibility of the media that's alternative in any way, shape, or form to not even talk what the duopoly message is and only to present those alternatives.
Man, that would be a wonderful world, wouldn't it, Mark? Unfortunately, we're going to have to create our alternative media to the mainstream media. You can't expect the mainstream guys, you know, to put their relationships with these politicians in jeopardy. They are not willing to do anything more than ask the most bland questions of these people or the most sort of politically acceptable controversial questions. They'll never stray into any of the real important areas that you or I might want to hear questions asked about, and they certainly won't allow anybody from the audience to ask those questions. Everybody is very carefully pre-screened at all of these events. All of these debates are super controlled just to make sure that nothing untoward happens towards these poor politicians on stage. Wouldn't want to have put them in a position of having to answer a question that they felt uncomfortable
about. If they did,
about.
Then that network would never get to do another debate again if one of those politicians is like, I'm not going to go in front of those people.
But that's the thing.
Well, that would be great, though. That would be great because then at least they would be challenged. The problem is that the refusal to challenge their duopoly system is only contributing to the continuation of it.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you. I really don't know how to, other than talking about it on the air, I don't have any solution.
You're spot on, Mark. Thanks for the call tonight. In fact, Mark Edge, my co-host, Mark.
Yeah, me.
Aren't we teaming up with I'm spacing on their name, but there's a group, like an independent group that's pushing for fairness in debates, open debates, I think is what they call themselves. I could be wrong about that.
Well, we've been in talks with them. Yeah. I haven't got a piece of paper.
Well, we're in talks with them about, you know, doing, we did this previously with them, like being a media sponsor for them and sponsoring the idea of having a true, you know, third party.
That was fair and equal.
Included debate. I thought they were the ones who reapproached us this year. Anyway, well, there's something going on behind the scenes. So we're doing a little more than talking about it. We're trying to throw whatever small amount of weight the show might have behind that particular organization and what they're up to. Because I support what, you know, Mark was calling about there. I think that we do need to have fairness in debates, and that in fairness would include anybody who's qualified on enough ballots to win in theory. So if you're in if you're on the ballot in two states, you can't win. But if you're on the ballot in 45 states, you could in theory win the election if enough people voted for you. I think that should really be the only qualifier as to who is allowed, because that whittles it down to like four or five people every
time. I'm not looking to keep people out of debates, but I think there does need to be some kind of qualification for a debate, and I think the Green Party and the Libertarian parties, that these organizations just don't get a fair shake.
They put in countless hours and thousands upon tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of dollars. I don't honestly know what it costs, because each state has different requirements as far as what it takes to actually get a third party candidate on the ballot. Usually the Libertarians get 49 or 50 states. I think the Greens got like 46 states last time. So they're all qualified, in enough places to actually be elected.
These are real candidates. The Libertarians had the former governor of New Mexico, two-time governor, and the Greens had Jill Stein. I did an interview with her. She's incredibly articulate, and these candidates deserve a fair shake.
Yeah.
And the American people deserve an opportunity to have somebody besides Crepe Sandwich A and Crepe Sandwich B.
You know, Mark, you said that the media, if one company were to actually do an honest debate where they asked tough questions, actually took uncensored questions from the audience, and further allowed third parties to actually be on the stage, that they would be blackballed essentially by the major political parties?
I would suspect, yeah.
But I bet you, even though the political party types would try to punish that media organization, I bet you that would be the most watched debate of all time. I bet you their ratings would go through the roof. It would be the most shared YouTube clips from a debate that ever happened. It would be a huge publicity boon if they had the courage to actually do it. And if they could build themselves to the point where, if it got them a lot of publicity, then the candidates would want to be a part of that debate in the future because they knew a lot of people were watching. But that's, in a crazy fantasy world, it's not
going to
happen.
It's not really. To some extent, that's what Donald Trump has done. Donald Trump is essentially an independent running as a Republican. That debate in which he just participated in was the most watched thing that Fox News has ever had. And
really?
Yes. In Fox News's history, that's their most watched thing. And so, yes, indeed, what you're saying is true. Sadly, it came in the form of Donald Trump, but there you go.
So you can share your thoughts on open debates. I hope that we'll see something like that, but it's so unlikely that the mainstream media is going to change how they approach these things and change their ways. They're so afraid of stepping on these political coattails.
I just want to make it clear to Donald Trump, if you're listening, hey, look, you know, we will give you the opportunity to talk on Free Talk Live. All you got to do is give us a call at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, you know, you'll get a chance to talk about all the policies you want to talk about. Yep, you're not my favorite candidate, buddy, but we'll make that possible for you.
Well, anyone can call into the show, Mark. I mean, you're not promising him anything
just
special.
Donald, just want to let him know. I know he's out there fuming if he's listening, right?
Like you're letting him know.
He constantly feels like the media is out to get him. And oh. I'm just saying, look, here's your opportunity, man.
So you're informing him of our open phones policy, not giving him preference over any other callers or anything like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The new report on the freedom of the countries around the world ranks the United States at number 20, putting countries like Chile and the United Kingdom ahead of the U.S. Last year, the U.S. was ranked 17th, but a steady decline of economic freedom and rule of law has dropped the level of freedom, according to the Cato Institute, Fraser Institute, and the Swiss Liberalis Institute, which created the study together. The author, co-author of the report, told the Daily Caller News Foundation that the steady growth of the government and increased regulations of business and labor contribute to the U.S.'s low rating. And by the way, this isn't like, don't think for a moment this is a Barack Obama thing, okay? This has been going down, the ranking of the United States has been going down for at least a decade and a half. We'll talk about it more here, and you can share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE.
His hair was falling out in clumps.
Our golden retriever, Sundance, he scratched incessantly.
Mounds and mounds of fur all over the place.
Our hairballs have hairballs.
Olive was suffering like a dog. She was itching, she was scratching, she was licking 24 hours a day.
Just chewing and chewing and chewing. So.
Scratching and biting.
Buddy, my Shih Tzu's itching problem, constantly licking his feet. It keeps me up at night.
And all it took was one container of Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acid.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
The shedding slowed down to almost none. The scratching went away after a few days.
Tons of energy. No more bad smells.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Sleep at night. Oh, let me do it again. Sleep at night. Get your dog some Dynavite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a four-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2% caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your four-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacral wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live's live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And join us on Skype as well. Skype username there is lrn.fm. You can call us that way. You'll sound a lot better when you do that. Coming up, a call from federal prison. We'll get to that here in a moment. I want to let you know how to protect yourself online first. ProXPN.com, code FTL50. That FTL50 gets you 50% off of this amazing virtual private network that encrypts your online data before it gets to your internet service provider. ProXPN does all of it right, offering OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption. Plus, it doesn't matter which operating system you're using or what device, Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, you can all use ProXPN. Get started at ProXPN.com. They accept credit card and even Bitcoin. Plus, unlike those other guys, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever, and they also now have more servers than ever before. When you use code FTL50 at ProXPN.com, you get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy their annual account, again with code FTL50. That breaks the price down to less than the price of a good cup of coffee. You can use code FTL50 at ProXPN.com right now and take back the privacy that is your right. We go to Matthew calling from federal prison. Used to call us from Marion in Illinois, but you are now in Texas. Matthew, what's going on?
Well, I complained about the censorship there, and I was filing a case, so they shipped me. But I got to see the magazine, and ironically, it was the June issue of Meyer's. It had a
of what? Which magazine? Ulrich.
Yeah.
Hold on. What?
Yeah, it was a Wired magazine.
A Wired magazine. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it had the article about Ross Ulbricht in it, and it had a cartoon of a nude woman in it. And they got tired of me complaining about their censorship, so they put me on Con Air and collect some frequent flyer miles.
So you literally got transferred because you complained about something?
About censorship, yeah.
It happens.
About First Amendment stuff, yeah, they hate that.
They just hate complaints, and at some point or another, they'll...
So they're not doing you a favor? What's their motivation for moving you? I guess I don't understand.
They hope that you'll just get tired and you won't pursue the case.
Okay. So they're moving
first
you constantly.
Federal prison.
Thank you for reminding me, lady. so they are... they're moving you around constantly, is what you're saying. How many different prisons have you been to?
I've been to 5 prisons in 5 years.
Okay. And so you just left Marion how long ago, and now you're in Texas?
I left Marion about a month ago.
And they think
I've
that you...
I've been here about a month. But, you know, they took the station that was there, that took you guys off the air, so I'm kind of, you know, it's good to be able to... I only get to hear you guys 2 days a week now, and not very well, but it's better than it was, where they... Marion, they shipped me and you.
Wow. So, wait, you're listening on the radio in Texas?
Well, actually, it's a station out of Ida, Oklahoma.
Oh,
it
interesting.
It doesn't come in real well, but we can hear it a couple days a week. And a lot of, you know, more guys are listening all the time as I tell them about it. It's very difficult, though.
Free Talk Live,
I
number
love
one
it.
In federal prison.
We are totally the number one show in federal prison. I think it's awesome. What we need to do is get some pirate radio operators to start, you know, running a good FM signal out there, you know, just outside of various different federal prisons all around the country. course.
That would be wonderful.
Yeah, I totally agree. So any good stories from, where is it, Siegelville?
Siegelville. No, it's I don't like it as much. You know, I can tell you the traveling con air is probably not as brutal as the traveling civilian. We don't have TSA. We have U.S. Marshals.
I'd still rather go through the TSA nude scanner machine than have to walk around in shackles.
Do you have to bend over and cough before you get on the plane? You know, one of a
absolutely.
Strip search?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, didn't TSA make you do that now?
Not quite.
Oh, that's weird. We heard that in here. I don't know. Is it just a bit
jail rumors?
Rumor?
Yeah, you know those jail rumors. Hey, good call, Matthew. Glad to hear from you again, and feel free to call us with any other jail stories
you
want to relate.
I'm glad to hear you guys.
Thanks, brother. Appreciate
the call
tonight. That dude paid. I don't know how much money to make that call.
No doubt.
That was a prepaid call from federal prison. And
medication.
I can tell you, it's not cheap to call local jails, let alone, or to call from a local jail, let alone to call across state lines from a federal prison. So thank you to all of our inmates who are literally captive audiences for Free Talk Live. All right, so we were talking about the rankings, the freedom right. rankings. Number 20 is the current ranking, down from 17 for the United States. And this is this has been going on for a long time. Also,
yeah, I remember the United States moving from like 7th to 10th, and
yeah.
It just keeps on sliding down the world's freedom charts. What are some of
this is Barack Obama's fault, though, Mark, isn't it? This is all the Obama administration.
The Obama administration could do something about it if it wished, but I think that this is a slide that's been going on longer than the Obama administration.
Since the year 2000, yeah. as a matter of fact.
So, you know, there was a Republican in office then. As a matter of fact, there was a Democrat in office in the year 2000.
That's
then,
true.
A Republican took over, and then a Democrat took over from there.
You remember the Republicans
said... This is a bipartisan slide down... you know, this is the Empire Mountain, slowly from, you know, a republic to an empire, I guess.
Well, you remember one Republican in the mid-aughts who said that they'd slashed the government to the bone.
Yeah, it's like DeLay or something.
I don't know. One of those guys.
Yeah.
I didn't believe him at that time.
Right.
But
under George Bush,
yeah.
when it was a Republican House, a Republican Senate, and a Republican White House, the Republicans had the audacity to say that a government that was larger than the Clinton administration's government had been slashed to the bone.
Yeah.
this is your small government party.
Right.
So,
here's the proof that it wasn't slashed.
If you believe
right?
in small government, you shouldn't be believing in the Republican Party.
You can't believe a word that comes out of these politicians' mouths, but you can believe the numbers. And these guys have run through the numbers on a variety of different factors. I'll give you the list of indicators here in a moment, but it's Ian Vasquez, who is the co-author of the report for the Fraser Institute, Cato Institute, and Swiss Liberalis Institute. He says that from the year 2000, the U.S. has been on a decline in terms of economic freedom. The other main reason for the U.S. low rank comes from the rule of law measure. Vasquez told the DCNF that the increased invasions of privacy through the war on drugs and now the war on terror have contributed to the decline in freedom. Also, the increased use of eminent domain is factored in as a violation of property rights.
Yeah, during the eminent domain case, and this is what really changed my mind on government, because I always kind of held out a hope for the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court ruled, and I can't remember when this was, 2005?
No. 2006? You were up here already.
That's not true.
I think were. I think that was 07 was the
okay,
the
somewhere
Kelo
in
case.
There in the Kelo against versus New London case, that the government could take things not for the public use but for public good, and the public good meant that, you know, they could give it to Pfizer.
You're right, 05.
And that's 2005. When it started, but then it was the finally you were right on when the Supreme Court made the ruling, though.
Really?
They weren't going to hear the case.
Okay.
So, you know, I mean, I lost hope at that point, and it isn't going to get any better. A plain reading of the Constitution isn't a plain reading of the Constitution. These people care nothing for the rule book that was written down. If they cared about the rule book, they'd change the rules to fit what people want, and they don't. They don't amend the Constitution. They just go around it and ignore it.
We will continue, and you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. How's it feel to know that the freedom is being destroyed in the United States and has been for a long time? The U.S. sliding down to number 20 on the list of economic freedom of the world. 855-450-FREE.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while, but once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. Live Saturday edition continues here. Are you shocked? Shocked that the United States is now ranked number 20 out of all of the world's various different countries on the Index of Economic Freedom? It's a study that is performed by, in this case, the Fraser Institute, Cato Institute, and Swiss Liberalis Institute. which I didn't know they were working together on this. I'd always thought it was the Fraser Institute, so maybe they brought in some extra help with this.
Now they're doing social rankings, too. So,
are they?
Yeah, there's an aspect in there that appears to be social rankings.
Well, I actually have the indicators that they used here. I'll go through those. But number 20, it's down from number 17 last year. Now, remember, there's a separate list, which is done by the Heritage Foundation. I don't recall at which number the U.S. is on their
list. It's higher than 20, but lower than 10.
That's right, yeah. So, and it's been dropping on that list as well. So they factor their factors in differently into coming up with their results. But nonetheless, the consistent message is things are not getting more free here in the United States. And I think people know it, that you know, you don't hear people saying as often, if at all, anymore, well, it's a free country, so blah, blah, blah. Well, no, it's not a free country, and it hasn't been a free country at any point in our lives, and it's certainly not getting more free. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Now, something you can do to help increase your freedom is taking responsibility for your finances, and that includes having alternatives to the U.S. dollar. Because if you just have all of your money, your value that you've created in life, if you just have it in the U.S. dollar or whatever your fiat currency, if you're in another country in the world, then you're not being very responsible at all with your money because you're just allowing politicians to debase the value of the currency. And that's what they do. They keep printing more of the money out, and then your money that you have in savings becomes worth less and less over time as a result of that, meaning that it doesn't buy as much, it doesn't go as far. And it's not good when that happens. So one of the things you can do to protect yourself is get some Bitcoin. And I also recommend gold and silver as well. It's good to diversify. So if you want to get gold and silver, you can go to gold.freetalklive.com. And if you want to get some Bitcoin or one of those alternative coins like Litecoin or Dogecoin, you can go to expresscoin.com. In the U.S. or Canada, they'll service pretty much everybody with the exception of New York, because New York just passed a terrible thing called the BitLicense. But if you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can probably use expresscoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone. You can do it with a money order or check. Go to expresscoin.com and use coupon code FTL. You'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency like Bitcoin with no fee whatsoever. So you've been thinking about Bitcoin? Well, the price has dropped actually over the last, about a week or so, Mark?
And ExpressCoin makes it really easy for you.
Yeah, so I mean, now that the price is down, maybe it... Well, you never know. It might continue going down. It might go back up. But if you've been thinking about getting Bitcoin, this is a good time to do it, I think. Go to expresscoin.com, especially if you're just going to turn right around and use it on something like saveitpurse.com, where you can just turn that into 20% off of your favorite items at Amazon. I mean, this is a no-brainer. So go to Express.
It's a no-brainer on why you should get Bitcoin and why you should be using saveitpurse.com.
And again, you can get the Bitcoin over at expresscoin.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. The U.S. at number 20 on the overall freedom ranking, just behind, or just, I guess, in front of the Czech Republic, Estonia, Belgium and Taiwan and Portugal. Those are the 21 through 25. We'll give you the top 10 here in a little bit. And you can, and we'll also talk about the factors that they factored into these rankings. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. Ethan is in Indiana listening to WIBC in Indianapolis.
Hi.
Hi. You're on the air.
Am I right now? Okay. Well, I just want to say I'm glad that there's at least one, I don't know how long it is, an hour or so, talk about everything in this country here. And I really don't normally listen to 93.1 because I grew up very Democratic family. You know, I voted Democrat for the last two elections, except for this past governor's election. I voted Libertarian.
Hey, right on.
You know, I kind of grew to know, like, these two-party system is just really, you know, unbelievable, and it's just, it sucks. And I'm a young person, I'm in my 20s, and I know it might be, like, you know, the mind of, like, oh, college grad, just getting out of college, but, you know, they do need more party representation, they need more people on stage to get media attention. And
Ethan, you're young. You're obviously a millennial, as they call that generation. What do your peers think about the choices? I mean, nobody's really fooled by this Republican Democrat crap, are they, in your age range?
Well, I might have to differ with that a bit, because I have seen a few friends go like hardline one or the other. Mm. And when I've even brought up to my, you know, Democrat friends, the certain ones of them, I say, well, look, this is what the Democrats did back in the 90s and Bill Clinton. And this is what they're doing now in other countries, you know, with drone strikes and everything. And they're telling me that I'm just attacking President Obama. I'm like, well, his policies are doing this to other people. And whereas, you know, I've never really tried to find common ground with other people. But, you know, now that I have tried to find common ground with people who I had previously ruled out as conservatives and like, oh, they're not going to buy anything I do. But some of my best friends who are pro-life but are also in very good favor of police accountability and taking out these private prison things, and at the same time they're conservative on other things. So I'm like, there is no, like, you can do other things. Like, this two-party system is just really controlling how people think and how people view, you know, the world around them.
They don't even really think a lot about it. I mean, a lot of people just absorb what they're told. They watch television, or they listen to talk radio.
They vote the way mommy and daddy voted.
There's that too. And, you know, they pick their experts and they believe whatever it is that they're told, and they just parrot the things that they say. And you're right, the two-party system, this two-party mentality, the left-right mentality, doesn't allow for nuance. It doesn't allow for people to say, oh, well, actually, I agree with, you know, liberty on economic issues and liberty on social issues. That doesn't fit you within either of the two parties.
Right. I mean, you know, it's fascinating when you find somebody who's actually a true blue Republican or true blue Democrat or true red Republican or whatever you want to call it, because can anyone possibly believe that one organization has a monopoly on good ideas? But some of them do. So it's like, yep, all the good ideas are from my party. And that's just, you know, hilarious. Because if that was the case, the country would be getting, you know, moving up the World Freedom Chart. It'd be getting better and better nominally. You know, there'd be less of a disparity between rich and poor. But these two parties have been in control for well over 100 years, and you've got what you got. It's not one party or the other, because we can look at states around the country where, you know, the Republicans control Texas, Utah, a variety of states in the South.
Indiana.
Democrats control Illinois, you know, Jersey, California, all over. Yeah. We know what these policies look like. You can look at the states. These policies stink.
Yep. And one thing for the Democratic side that I constantly heard throughout the last few years, and said, like, well, look, I want to vote independent. And they all tell me, well, no, don't. And I say, well, both parties suck. And they're like, well, you know, vote for the lesser evil. I'm like, you're just admitting that they're evil.
Yep.
So why would I vote for the lesser evil? Like,
there's a better argument even than that.
an argument to vote for the two parties?
Right. Because the fact is that in any election you voted in, it is highly unlikely that you've been the deciding vote. Here, the way in the United States, the way the voting system works, one vote makes the difference. And any vote above that one vote, you know, winner takes all with one vote.
Well, that sounds like a reason to vote for the independents.
It is a vote for the independents. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, okay.
It doesn't matter a vote for the lesser of two evils, because that really doesn't make the difference. What matters is that, you know, your vote is wasted if you voted for the losing candidate, whether the losing candidate lost by one or whether they lost by 100.
For me, it's not about voting, you know, and what happens externally. It's about being able to live with myself, and I can only vote for somebody that actually is advocating for freedom, or maybe like a troll vote like Vermin Supreme for fun. Hey, thanks for the call, Ethan. I appreciate you listening down there in Indy. And to anybody who's listening on the radio and you only get one show a week, we do seven. So you can always call the program director during the business week and tell him or her thank you for airing Free Talk Live and ask for some more. 855-450-FREE.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates, or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education, or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting. ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue. I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Healthy elimination is essential to high energy, a cheerful mood, and prevention of disease. Some of the founders of our modern holistic health thinking state that disease begins in a toxic colon. A toxic intestinal tract is the foundation for virtually all degenerative disease, and a clean and well-moving intestinal tract is the foundation of health.
I just want to say that you folks have an amazing product. I've taken whey protein products for years, and I've never noticed the results I have with your product. I've suffered with bouts of constipation most of my life. Within a few days of taking One World Whey, I noticed a dramatic change. Also, in the past few years, I've experienced symptoms associated with diabetes. I feel horrible when I've had too much sugar, and I've been getting the foot pain as well. But I've noticed in the past week or so, I'm not feeling bad anymore, and the foot pain is gone. I'm just finishing up a 5-pound tub I ordered and just got off the phone ordering more. I love your product. Thank you.
Call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. Or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here. Toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And of course, you can join us online. We've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. We're going to go to your calls and thoughts, but want to recap for those of you just tuning in. Number 20. That is the current ranking, and it is not doing better, of the United States. Amongst all the countries of the world that have been surveyed by the Fraser Institute, Swiss Liberalis Institute, and the Cato Institute in their study about the economic freedom of the world. It apparently came out fairly recently with, of course, number one being Hong Kong. Yet again. In fact, Hong Kong has been at the top of this chart as long as we have been talking about this chart. And which has probably been a decade. We've probably been talking about this for a decade.
Yeah, Hong Kong's not really a country, but it is an independent area in many ways.
Yeah, I mean, it certainly was kind of its own country until it got absorbed by China.
It's still a protectorate of England, but yeah, I mean,
it's always had some level of independence. And even after, what was it, 97 when that happened, when the when England gave it up?
99, maybe?
I think it was 97.
Okay.
But when they gave it up, they, you know, they still kind of left it alone. The Chinese government sort of let it
be. Making money.
Yeah, exactly. So what were you going to say about Hong Kong?
Well, there were some protests recently, I think it was within the last year, about sort of some freedoms that they wish to have. But even on that, when you look at the social freedoms that they enjoy in Hong Kong, they're still greater than they are here in the United States.
The factors used to make this list, this is according to dailycaller.com, included security and safety, movement, religion, association, assembly and civil society, expression, relationships, size of government, legal system, and property rights, as well as access to sound money, freedom to trade internationally, regulation of credit, labor, and business. So these were some of the things they considered. There are likely dozens and dozens of pages in their report if you'd like to actually take it and take the time to read it. Number two on the list, Switzerland. Three, Finland. Four, Denmark. New Zealand at number five. Canada at number six. Australia at seven. Ireland.
So Canada is at number six.
Six, yeah.
And we're told in this country that Canada is this socialist country. And I think that that's really important to look at. What are the economic and social freedoms in Canada versus the United States? Don't they list that on that chart?
I don't have that chart. I just have the top 25.
Okay. I'm sorry, I thought it was on there. I, you know, obviously they fit together significantly higher than the United States, and I think that's interesting that so many people in the U.S. think, you know, the United States is so much better than Canada, and Canada is showing up. This is the Cato Institute and the Fraser Institute putting this list together. These
are U.S.-based groups.
Yeah, these aren't exactly liberal organizations. These are conservative organizations, at least fiscally conservative organizations, that are pointing out a real problem going on in the United States.
Number seven, Australia. Eight, Ireland. Nine, the United Kingdom. And 10, Sweden. And when you get down into 10 through 20, I don't even know how you pronounce this one. Mauritius? It's an African island nation? Have you ever pronounced that one, Mark?
I don't know. No, I'm not looking
Mauritius
at the list.
There you go. Mauritius. The computer has pronounced it for us. Mauritius, which is officially the Republic of Mauritius, and it is number 19 on this list. So that, I don't know if that's the first time. I think it may very well be the first time an African nation has actually bested the United States on this list.
Hmm.
Very interesting. You can share your thoughts here with us. Chile at 18, Luxembourg at 17, Malta at 16.
I want you to ask yourself, radio listener, which one of the candidates that you're hoping to vote for is going to move the United States up the world freedom charts? Because I can't think of very many of them who are. It's certainly not going to be Trump. It's not going to be Clinton. It's not going to be Bush. This isn't, no.
Even if your boy Rand Paul gets in there, I don't know if he's going to have that great of an effect.
I don't know what his effect will be.
It's hard for one man to change the flow of the U.S. government.
I don't suspect he will. It will be his efforts that push it downward.
They missed number 15 on this list here.
Are there two 14s either?
There are, you're right. Yeah, two 14s. Netherlands and Iceland, Germany at 12, Austria at 12, and Norway at 11. So yeah, I guess they tie some of these countries.
That's how it's done, yep.
So let's go to the calls. Your thoughts here. Actually, 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Just having some difficulty with the phones. So, you know, things aren't getting better in the United States. Everybody, you know, nobody says anymore that this is a free country. And nobody's even calling tonight to claim that it is. Could anyone actually do that? Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Could anyone really look someone straight in the eye, which you can't do because we're on the radio? But could you look someone straight in the eye and tell them that this is a free country?
I do hear people say it's the greatest nation on earth still.
Well, now, I guess you would have to qualify that.
That's a much more subjective statement.
Yeah, you'd have to qualify that statement. By greatest, if you mean like dominating the rest of the world with military strength, okay.
Because that's kind of, I mean, you know, to some extent, that's what great means, right? Alexander the Great. Was this huge, you know, world conqueror.
The more people you destroy, right, the more great you are.
They don't call Genghis the Great, though, and he conquered significantly more. But, I mean, you know, great can very well mean the most powerful in the sense of, you know, military strength. So, yes, you know, my nation could beat up your nation. We got that. But I don't know that I necessarily want to be one of, because as a citizen of the U.S., I'm just responsible for paying for this war machine. These people I'm supposedly keeping the shipping lanes open for and freeing their countries, they're not paying for that stuff. And not that they even necessarily asked for it.
So if it was greatest, as in like it's the greatest country as far as freedom is concerned, we know that's not true by a variety of different factors. So you know, what do you think about the United States? I mean, is anybody still laboring under the delusion that they are free people? No doubt the U.S. is more free than most places because there are still 160-something countries below it on the list, right? So it's certainly better than a lot of countries, but it's not free. What do you think? 855, 450 free.
I think it's a good place to make money still. There's a lot of, you know, the legacy of freedom in the U.S.
Free speech is relatively free here.
You can
still
complain. Yep. There's no doubt about that. And I'm sure there's somebody out there on the radio who's, you know, our people fought and died for your right to say what you're saying.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, yeah, you're right. There's the ability to complain, certainly. But I think
and that is worth a lot. Right? That is worth a lot. Even in Canada, you don't even have that much free speech.
Less so.
Yeah.
But it's still, you know, more so than most of the world. But it's that legacy. Freedom is what makes a nation wealthy. And that means the United States, with less freedom, will become, over time, less wealthy.
That's true.
What's going to happen is the money will coalesce into the hands of few. Those few people, politicians will come after them for their money. Those few will say, you know what? Things are better in another country, and they will leave. They will go to Jersey or the Isle of Man, or they'll go to the you know, Cayman or wherever.
Mauritius. They'll go to Mauritius.
They may go to Mauritius. And any of these places in order to hold on to their wealth. And this is how we live in a global society. You can't just tax your rich anymore. You have to provide better goods and you better have to provide better services as a government. You have to provide better services. And monopolies, which governments are, they claim a monopoly over a given land area. They're traditionally very bad at providing good customer service at low prices. It takes competition to do that. I wonder if people think that a republic or a democracy or whatever you want to call it is it the end-all be-all of human governance?
This is the greatest system in the world.
Right. Are we 300 years out of autocracies, monarchies, into you know, these republics, and this is it?
It's still the best.
This is the best thing we can come up with, because I don't think it is. I think that we can
have... Proof's in the pudding. It's not the best.
I think we can have... Well, I mean, the rest of those countries really are only a slightly different. A parliamentary setup rather than, you know, whatever we've got in the Constitution.
Well, the best, in our opinion, obviously, is true freedom, but no one's trying that.
Well, that's what I'm talking about here, is the opportunity for governments to not be tied to land masses, to provide their services independent of a geographic area. And governments are all about geographic areas. They're like, this insurance company can't do business in this state, and this state won't allow this insurance company to do their, you know, like these kind of things. What if governments didn't do that? What if they weren't tied to land masses?
You know, Estonia, which is number 22, Estonia on this list, is now offering the e-citizenship thing, which is pretty cool. It's not true citizenship. It's not like you can get a passport with it or anything like that. But I think it's a step in that direction where you can apply for this and that it can benefit you to like start a business in Estonia and that kind of thing.
With communication via the internet speeding up so much, customer service is going to necessarily have to get better. There are 180-something, 200 nations, whatever they are, depends on who you ask. And those nations do have to compete with each other. And with increasing communications, I'm wondering what we're going to get in the future.
All right. Whether you want to talk about Ashley Madison, I think we got that coming up as well. You can join us here, especially if you believe the U.S. is the freest country in the world. Want to hear from you. 855-450-FREE.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Geico applauds your inner road name.
A slow clap goes out to your biker alter ego. You might be mild-mannered Michael in the office, the guy known for raising his hand in meetings, but out on the open road, it's Motor Mike. Geico supports you and your bike, Motor Mike, because beyond cars, Geico insures motorcycles, those glorious vroom vroom machines. With 24/7 customer service and great rates, the only thing you'll be raising from now on is a heck of a good time. So head out on the highway and make that road yours, Mike. Make it yours.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
The Ethan Behrman Show on the Future of Talk Radio, GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. A military jet taking part in a British air show crashed into a busy main road Saturday, killing 7 people and injuring more than a dozen others. West Sussex Police Superintendent Jane Derrick tells Sky News all of the fatalities were located at the crash site.
As far as we are aware, all of those who sadly lost their lives were on the road, and it was nobody within the air show perimeter on the actual airport.
Meanwhile, Parliament Minister Tim Loughton, who represents Worthington East and Shoreham, cautioned against calling air shows unsafe.
This is an air show that's been going for 26 years. Only the second time there's been any serious accident, and the first time that spectators and people on the ground have been affected, bad though that is.
Witnesses on the ground say, though, it appeared the Hawker Hunter fighter jet was unable to successfully pull out of a loop maneuver. Also at SRNnews.com, officials in Washington State are recruiting volunteers to help fight a massive wildfire that's expanded to 355 square miles in the Ogonagon complex. Out-of-work logger Jack Cutchy says getting paid to help with the fire helps both his loggers and the community.
We probably won't be back to work logging for a month or two. So, yeah, got to keep going.
3 firefighters died in the complex earlier last week. Officials are hoping calmer, cooler winds helped their efforts over the weekend. Authorities in France are interrogating a 26-year-old Moroccan man who was subdued by 3 Americans on a high-speed European train Friday. The man was on security watch list after Spanish authorities alerted French intelligence last year that he belonged to the radical Islamic movement. The 3 Americans got a phone call from President Obama today, who praised them for their heroic deeds. One American who was an American Air Force airman, suffered slight wounds to his hand during the subduing of the attacker. This is SRN News.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360 to talk to a certified counselor.
I had heard about Trinity, so I made the call. They took care of all of my credit cards, and now I am completely debt-free.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360.
My name is Anne, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-758-5360.
The Minnesota Vikings, already bound for a glitzy new stadium, could have another move in store.
The football team's ownership has announced the signing of a purchase agreement for an Eagan property. It could become its headquarters and training facility. The 185-acre parcel was once home to Northwest Airlines' corporate headquarters. The Vikings' main off-the-field presence has been in Eden Prairie for more than 30 years, but the team's chief operating officer says the team has outgrown Winter Park and faces restraints on expansion there.
Correspondent Rich Thomason says the team will move into a $1 billion plus Minneapolis stadium due to open next year. Before their game with the Cleveland Indians this afternoon, the New York Yankees retired Jorge Posada's number 20. The former catcher spent 17 seasons in the Bronx. On Sunday, the Yankees will retire pitcher Andy Pettitte's number 46. This is SRN News. Florida Governor Rick Scott won't force legislators to return to the state capitol.
The legislature ended its 12-day special session Friday without reaching an agreement on new congressional districts for the state. Scott has the power to call legislators back to work, but a spokeswoman for the Republican governor said that Scott would not intervene in the dispute. The Florida Supreme Court ruled in July that current districts don't meet a voter-approved constitutional amendment requiring districts to be compact and not drawn to benefit a political party or incumbents. Patrick Voss, SRN News.
Weather forecasters say Tropical Depression Kilo is expected to gradually strengthen and could pass Kauai as a hurricane next week. Kilo was about 520 miles south of Honolulu Saturday morning, could become a tropical storm by Sunday night, and possibly a hurricane by Thursday. It's all determining by which way it turns northward. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, especially if you want to go to bat for the United States. If you think the U.S. is the freest country in the world, well, the Cato Institute, the Fraser Institute, the Heritage Foundation, they all disagree with you. The numbers show the U.S., at least from the Fraser Institute's report, which they worked with Cato on that, at number 20. Now, I've actually tried to pull up the full publication, Mark. Have you seen the full report?
I did, yeah.
Okay, I cannot find it. I only had the story from the Daily Caller, and over at freetheworld.com, they have a 2014 report, but it seems to have 2012 numbers in it, so I'm a little confused. See if I can remedy that here as the show rolls on. But the important part about Free Talk Live is your phone calls and thoughts, so let's go to the phones and the fun. We'll start with Norbert, listening in Wisconsin.
Hello.
Hey, to the mic in Madison. Go ahead, Norbert. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hello. Good evening.
Welcome, sir.
I feel some sort of obligation to put this information out there for America's young people because I'm not young anymore, and I've had to think about it for 52 years. It explains what this country's about, and we don't need to talk about democracy. That's a bunch of nonsense. There are probably two handfuls of people right now who wring their hands every morning because the assassination of John F. Kennedy is not buried in history, and they're worried because somebody might tell the truth and come out and handcuff them and take them away. And all the
what is the truth? What is the truth about John F. Kennedy? Is that what you're getting at?
I'll tell you what it is. You can get an author named John O. Douglas, who wrote a book, which is one of the most well-documented books I've ever read, on the it is entitled The Assassination of John F. Kennedy, Why He Died and Why It Matters. And Nigel Peterson, the producer in the United Kingdom of a documentary history called The Assassination of John F. Kennedy.
Okay. So I'm not going to spend the time that it takes to actually go and watch or read any of those things. Maybe somebody listening will do that if they're that into it. But can you summarize, give me the executive summary, if you will, of what the, you know, your point is here?
The point I'm making is that on Friday morning, November 22nd, John F. Kennedy got off the plane and said, we'll be out of Vietnam by Christmas. The assassination of John F. Kennedy turned this country into the oligarchy that Jimmy Carter said it is right now. It turned 300 million people into slaves.
I don't understand that point.
End the Vietnam War. That's my point.
What makes you think the hundreds of millions of people in the U.S., I don't think we were at 300 at that time, but the hundreds of millions of people in the U.S. Were not slaves before John F. Kennedy was assassinated?
200 million.
Yeah. What makes you think that they were not slaves prior to his assassination?
I did not say that they were not. I'm saying that was the icing on the cake.
Well, you said they turned it. You turned them into slaves. So you were just being hyperbolic then. Hey, thanks for the call, Norbert. Appreciate it. I just find it less than concerning as far as what the truth is behind the John F. Kennedy assassination. I really, you know, it seems like it's not particularly relevant to our lives today.
Well, everybody seems to have this point in history when things sort of
went
awry. Some people will say it was under Nixon with the changing of the dollar off
taking
of the
away
gold,
the silver yeah, backing
yeah, off the gold standard from an international standpoint. Some people will say it's, you know, it was under Carter, it was under Reagan,
1913 with the founding of the IRS and the Federal Reserve.
Right, sure,
that's a big one.
Some people will say Woodrow Wilson. Some people will say FDR.
Some people would say the signing of the Constitution.
Some people would say Lincoln. Constitution's a big one because he went off of the Articles of Confederation.
Right.
And it was really, it was a coup in many ways.
There was the time when the U.S. went bankrupt or whatever in the 30s.
Yep, right, yeah. Under FDR. And so everybody's got this point in history when it all went bad. And I can't answer that. I cannot tell you when it went bad or whatever. But I mean, you know, we can sort of look throughout history, see what's better and see what's worse about different eras and try to make things better. But I don't think that the JFK assassination is particularly meaningful to most people today. I just don't think it matters to them.
Let's talk to Greg. He's in Indiana listening to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hello, Greg.
Hello there. Thanks for taking my call and enjoy your show. I wish it was more than once a week, but that's the way it is. I'm a small business owner. I purchased a business about 4 years ago, and on a $500,000 purchase, between the buyer and the seller, legal fees, accounting fees, surveys, permits, almost $70,000 to get the deal done.
Wow! So it cost you $570,000 to do a $500,000 deal.
No, the $70,000 was split between the buyer and the seller.
I see.
But just that total number is what it took to get the deal done today, and it just, you know, that's just ridiculous.
Well, Greg, don't you know the government's just trying to protect you? I mean,
it's the price of freedom, Greg.
Yeah, they're just trying to keep you safe. This is the price of civilization. I mean, you know, you'd be living in North Korea. Oh, wait, no, they've got government there too.
Yeah, you signed the social contract, didn't you, Greg?
Something like that. And now, I mean, between payroll taxes and property taxes and personal property taxes and, you know, self-employment taxes and insurance, I mean, it's oppressive. And when I hear someone say, oh, I wish I could own my own business, I'm just like, okay.
know.
Yeah, they don't know what it's like.
A lot of small business people are able to, there's some advantages to being in a small business from a tax standpoint, and there's some advantages to being an employee. I don't think employees have it that particularly great either.
Yeah. But that was my comment. My question is regarding the ranking of those countries in the top 20, you mentioned Denmark and Sweden, which, you know, some of the countries that reaction is to, well, those are socialist countries, but obviously things that maybe have changed since I've looked closer at their government policies. But in the past, they've had marginal tax rates of 60, 70, 80%. How can a country with that high marginal tax rate be considered economic freedom? I'm sure the formula that the Institute is using is somewhat complicated, but I'm shocked that.
Good question.
Yeah, I'll handle that. So both Denmark and Sweden do score lower than the United States on the economic freedom aspect. I'm looking at the chart here for 2015, and so you rightly discern that they are considered to be less economically free than the United States. Their social freedoms buoy them up on the list. But I'd also like to point out that these countries don't have, when the United States tax system's put into play, you're talking about a federal tax system, a state tax system, counties, cities. Sometimes there's municipal breakdowns beneath that, and even to some extent, homeowners associations, not that those would be counted. But you're looking at a pile of taxes as opposed to one VAT. When you have, these countries, it's easy to look at what their tax rate is there in those countries. It's hard to look at it here in the United States for the average individual. The other thing I'd point out is the United States isn't the tax rate isn't that much lower in the United States. It's just that it's split up a bunch of different revenue taxation organizations. And the other thing is that those countries aren't spending nearly as much on military per capita as the United States is. So what you'll see, as far as single payer health care or something like that, that money is being funneled in different directions.
Yeah.
Tell me something, Mark. I'm curious about this report. So you said the Cato Institute, and there's a Swedish institute as well that had gotten involved.
The Institute Liberty.
Have they changed the name of the report? Because it used to be the Economic Freedom of the World, and it was focused more on economic freedoms, but yet still Switzerland and those other countries were performing relatively well.
It's called the Human Freedom Index, a global measurement of personal, civil, and economic freedom.
That would be why I couldn't find it. Hey, thanks for the call, Greg. I appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number for you to join us here. Do you believe still the story that the United States is the freest country in the world? I don't know if there's people out there like that anymore. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. What about that Ashley Madison hack? That's coming up on Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to IDStronghold.com and get the facts and the wallet, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit idstronghold.com today.
Are you excited about the World Wide Web? Do you want a place where you can share your ideas and express yourself? Well, dial up your modems and stream on down to the GCN Live Community Forum. Lots of radical features await you there.
Wow, Internet guy, I am so glad I went to the GCN Live Community Forum.
You too can discover why the World Wide Web is awesome. Just go to gcnlive.com/forum. That's gcnlive.com/forum. I'll see you in cyberspace. Friend GCN Live on Diaspora and Cross.tv.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course you can join us here toll-free on the live Saturday edition. The number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The United States ranked at number 20 on the new, what is called now the Human Freedom Index, which is why I was having trouble finding it on the Fraser Institute's website, because it's no longer hosted at the Fraser Institute. It is Cato.org that's hosting it. I'll put a link to the full report up on our Facebook and Twitter here in a moment.
Yeah, if you want more freedom in your life, you're probably not going to get it from governments generally. One way to get it is by opting out and getting into the international currency, Bitcoin. Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. It's a prime online destination for information about the Bitcoin, about Bitcoin and the digital currency industry. Their website integrates a community forum breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. They aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has a very sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and much more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts. Bitcoinist.net.
Yep. So if you go to Free Talk Live's Facebook page and or Twitter, you should find the latest post, which has the full PDF, all 100-something pages of it. So you are welcome to parse through this at your leisure. They tell you more about the methods and what they factored in. And you're right, Mark, they did start factoring in personal freedom into this, which is probably one of the reasons why the U.S.
It's a much more valuable list.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm really excited about it, because one of my biggest critiques previously of these lists was, it only really looked at economic freedom. And now this is a more well-rounded report. So good for them for doing that. By the way, at the very bottom of the list, it went down to about number 152. It was Iran down at the very bottom of the barrel. But North Korea, for instance, isn't ranked. So the reason for that is that there's no information you can get from North Korea. They're not giving you reports And even if they did give reports, no one would trust the accuracy of the information in those reports. So not every country in the world is listed in this particular ranking.
Liechtenstein isn't on there. It's likely to have been in the top 10.
That's too small, right? Like there's a certain population requirement.
I don't know precisely. You know, I haven't read through the whole 150 pages. I just know that not all the nations are represented.
Now, the number six country on that list, Canada, is where this next story is from, where Ashley Madison is being targeted by a class action lawsuit in Canada over the privacy breach. In case you haven't heard, probably one of the largest hacks of any company that has ever occurred as far as public data released being, you know, there have been a lot of hacks of different companies, but this is data that has been released to the public of this company's files. Ashley Madison was an online, it's hard to really call it a dating site. It's kind of like a hookup site for people who are married. The pitch of Ashley Madison was that you would get laid if you signed up for the site and paid $250 a month. Like it was a guaranteed affair is what they said. And we were talking with Chris Cantwell from ChristopherCantwell.com last night on the show. He's done a lot of investigating into Ashley Madison. And he said that this $250 package basically is prostitution. They're guaranteeing somebody to have sex outside of marriage. And the only way you can guarantee that for somebody is if you're willing to hire them
a
prostitute.
A hooker, right?
So, yeah, I really wonder what's going on behind the scenes at Ashley Madison. And I imagine that we are just about barely scratching the surface of the 30 gigs of data that has now been released, which, from what I understand, includes all of the messaging system from Ashley Madison's site, so anyone sending messages back and forth, all of the emails used to register accounts, all of the credit card data used to run charges. This and presumably with the size of 10 gigs for the first release and 20 gigs for the next release, that probably includes people's pictures, I would guess. You know, I haven't seen that personally yet, but a friend of mine was actually looking through some of this data, and the damning information that could be in this definitely is in this particular file. I'm sure people are just barely getting a handle on it. There's just so much data.
Well, there's a great deal of data released, and it should be interesting to see how things you know, parse out. I would imagine some political careers are going to be ruined. I think politics is probably the big one here. You know, there might be some captains of industry that that get it, but I can't imagine that there's too
many.
Or
maybe some Hollywood stars or something like that.
You think that anyone cares as far as a Hollywood
star? People love the Hollywood news, man. I mean, this entertainment
news is huge. I'm not saying that the
news
isn't going to come out. I'm saying their career is probably not going to be ruined.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
I mean, I can't imagine that's going to... you know,
there's well, they're cheating all the time, right?
That's what I see. Yeah. Is that there seems to be no sexual scandal too bizarre, besides poor Pee Wee Herman, that's going to ruin a career.
He's back, man. They're making a new Pee Wee movie.
Whatever.
So I hear. Let's go to Jim. We'll talk more about Ashley Madison here in a moment. Jim, listening to KGOE in Eureka, California. Hey, Jim.
Yeah. Thank you for taking my call.
Sure.
I wanted to just relate, in 1969, Christmas time, I was down in Laredo, Texas, and I met this German professor. I was in jail, and they arrested him. He came in to the jail, and he said, "You people live in a police state." He was so shocked. He was visibly shocked. He could not believe America was such a police state. And how long ago was that? Let's see, 41, 51, 56 years ago or something like that?
And where was he from again? I'm sorry.
Years ago. He was from Germany.
Oh, yeah.
And he said, "You people live in a police state." And I mean, he said with all the German, you know, authority that they, you know, they have anyway. He was just shocked. He could not believe it.
And what did you think about that at that time?
Well, I knew it was a police state. I knew it was when I was 12 years old, they came to my school in the sixth grade and told me when I get 18, they're going to lock me up, all right?
Why did they tell you that?
You can't do nothing until you get a B. All because I was a cocky little punk, you know.
Gotcha.
And so two detectives told me that. And sure enough, at 18, they had me in jail. And
they made good.
Out, you know what I'm
yeah. Jim, thanks for calling and sharing that story tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. It's certainly true that the people who have been a part of totalitarian regimes around the world, whether it be Hitler's Germany or some of the terrible rulers in Russia, you know, you put those people in a new place, and they are Johnny on the spot, accurate at detecting what's going on. And we've had people call this show over the years and say similar things like, yeah, I moved here from Russia. I'm not saying I did. This is what somebody might tell us on the air. Oh, yeah, I moved here from Russia 10 years ago and was shocked at how unfree you guys are and that, you know, you are living in a police state. And he's saying that happened 50 years ago.
I can't tell you how many Eastern Bloc countries I've heard people say that it's just your politicians are just like our politicians, that there's, you know, not much different. I look at these charts and I see countries that are, you know, less economically and socially free than the United States. And so I'm like, but I can see the point they're trying to make. The U.S. is going in the wrong direction, pretty obviously, for the last 15 or 20 years. We're looking at this chart from 2015, but the numbers are from 2012 because they obviously can't study numbers, you know, current numbers.
Right.
They, you know, they have to have time to accumulate these things. So I think it was around the turn of the millennium that the U.S. began to really slide down the chart. That means those numbers were from 3 years prior to that. It's been, you know, going on 20 years now.
Germany, by the way, just a reminder, number 12 on the current listing of most free economically and socially, so just overall human freedom. Number 12 for Germany. Congratulations to them. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. You can join us, share your thoughts here. This is Free Talk Live.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. SimpliSafe Home Security. SimpliSafe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimpliSafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimpliSafeDefense.com. SimpliSafeDefense.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the Sacro Wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
The human body is more than 60% water.
Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. The live Saturday edition continues, and you can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And if you support Free Talk Live, you want to get behind the show for $5 a month, we'll get you some perks. You get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines. There's a special podcast just for Free Talk Live amplifiers. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote, and it's $5 a month. We'll take that money in, invest it into Free Talk Live, get on more radio stations around the country, more internet listeners around the globe, more satellite listeners as well. Please go to amp.freetalklive.com. You can use any major credit card via PayPal, or you can also use Visa and MasterCard right there on our website, amp.freetalklive.com. AshleyMadison.com, the hack that was talked about previously has now resulted in approximately 30 gigs of data being released. There was a 10 gig data release initially, 20 gigs came later. The first 10 gigs is just raw data from the site of credit card transactions, overtime, email addresses, purportedly the messaging system as well.
The messaging system. Yeah, so you can see the messages that go back and forth.
Messages sent from people who are intending to cheat on their spouse.
Yeah.
Mostly men, by the way. From what I understand about AshleyMadison.com, there were a lot of fake profiles that the site would create that, according to ChristopherCantwell.com, when you would sign up for Ashley Madison as their free account, they would then have robots send you messages from these hot girls' accounts like, oh, let's talk.
Sure, but you're interesting,
you
buddy.
Can't respond to them until you pay for the site. And so then when you pay the $20 to get in, you then respond to one of these hotties or whatever, and of course they don't say anything back to you at that point. So there was like sort of an alleged scam going on here.
Yeah, who are you going to complain to? Right?
Yeah, right.
You gonna file a lawsuit?
Hey, I want my damn affair. Well, now there is a lawsuit, and according to Vice News at vice.com, there's a suit coming from Canada. Elliot Shore, an Ottawa resident who joined the website for a short time in search of companionship that he never found after his wife of 30 years died of breast cancer, strange site to join after your wife dies, is the plaintiff of a proposed $760 million suit filed this week in Ontario against Avid Life Media, which is Ashley Madison's parent company. And the legal action, which still requires certification, alleges the privacy of many thousands of Canadians was breached in July when hackers infiltrated Ashley Madison and downloaded private information from the website. The website, which bills itself as, quote, the most famous name in infidelity and married dating, unquote, purports to have some 39 million members worldwide, although there's no telling how many of those are bogus accounts. The hacktivists, identifying themselves as the Impact Team, posted nearly 10 gigs of user information on Tuesday, including passwords, credit card numbers, transaction details. By the way, if you had an account on Ashley Madison and you're one of those people who uses the same password for everything, you should go and change that password on all the other websites you go to right now, because hackers around the world and everybody who doesn't know how to hack but who can download the hacked information now has your password.
There are people scrambling for their computers all over America.
And your email address, so they can link those together. The hackers say the break-in was motivated by ALM's dubious privacy policies and questionable business practices. They released a manifesto threatening the release of the information if the site wasn't taken down, and the company did not take their site down, so they kept their word and released all of the data. They called the company's full delete feature a profitable scam, accusing the company of keeping the purchase details, names, and addresses of customers after the customer paid to have their information completely erased.
Oh, I'm sure they did. I can't imagine a lot of companies actually get rid of information.
Well, that is fraud, right? Like they said, okay, you give us the $19, we'll pull your information from our database. We'll erase you from our website. But they did not do that. The Ontario man, or an Ontario man who lives in Mississauga, told the Toronto Sun, quote, "I haven't been on the site in a long, long time." This was after they released his info in July to show the material that it had was genuine. He claimed he never had actually used it to cheat on his wife of 20 years and that he had paid to have his personal data erased from the site. It appeared the company had evidently kept that information in some form despite him paying for that service. So whether this suit is going to go anywhere or not, I think, remains to be seen. Obviously, even a company that has really good security measures can still be hacked. Anybody can... With the right determination, whether it's somebody who wants to break into a computer system or someone who wants to get past a locked front door or something like that. Anybody with the determination and the knowledge can get through whatever the security is. As long as you have enough determination, knowledge, and time, you can get through whatever security is in your way. So, you know, whether or not Ashley Madison should be held liable for losing all of this data, I don't know. But could they be found liable for, you know, not doing what they said they were going to do? Yeah, I think so. If they said they were going to remove your data from their files, you paid them $19 and then they didn't do that. That's certainly a breach of contract. Now, whether it's worth your time to try to get $19 back out of it or, you know, whatever the damages are going to be on that, again, it all remains to be seen.
I think this is a big, you know, it's a learning opportunity. Ashley Madison hung this this treat out for philanderers, mm-hmm. and a lot of them took it. And so, you know, there's an opportunity to learn from it and say, yeah, well, maybe that shouldn't be done again.
Your thoughts are welcome. 855-450-FREE. You can also bring up anything. Let's go to Aaron listening in Montana. In Bozeman to KMMS. Hello, Aaron.
How are you guys doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Yes, sir. That Ashley Madison thing, those guys get what they deserve. That's pretty... I don't know. I don't even know what to think about that. But I just wanted to bring up about the freest countries. Sorry to change the subject.
No, it's a free talk live. Please, go ahead.
There's a quality of freedom. And then I believe that, yeah, we are losing our freedoms left and right. But we do have a quality of freedom. And I think that the Second Amendment, the right to own and bear arms, the fact that we are an armed society puts us above any of those that aren't, because we still do have, I mean, slim as it may be, the chance to regain all freedom with that Second Amendment. Jefferson said that it would be a teeth of the Constitution. So I think if you take it in, you take that list and kind of, yeah, I don't know if I really agree with it a whole lot.
One of the things I wondered about the list is the United States has 50 different states, and they have different levels of freedom within those states. And how does the freest state in the United States, and I couldn't tell you which one that is at this moment in time, but I know New Hampshire ranks in the top five. How does it compare to the freest country?
I want to know that,
and
too.
These kind of things. And I say also, when you look at freedom, the thing that you value is important, right? Like, so if you live in Switzerland and surfing is important to you, you don't have the kind of freedom that's important. Now, from my standpoint, I think that if you like to shoot guns, you know, this specialized sort of fireworks that is guns, or to go hunting, most of these nations, Canada, that sort of thing, you can go hunting, but there's a lot of rules around owning guns there. I don't feel like the Second Amendment has done a very good job of securing the freedoms in this country. The fact that the United States is at position 20 shows that the Second Amendment is a poor bulwark against the sliding of freedom.
And it certainly hasn't stopped the destruction of liberty.
Well, I'd like to argue that, you know, perhaps you don't spank your kid on his first offense. You know, maybe you, the third, fourth time you tell them behave and they don't, then you gotta tune them up a little bit. But maybe it's that way with the government. Maybe we need to get to 25 before people in the country stand up and say they've had enough. I don't know. You know, I just it was a
thought.
I think a lot of people are frustrated. I mean, if you look at the Tea Party, you look at Occupy, these are two of the popular protest movements.
Even the Bernie Sanders campaign that's out there where everybody's, what they're upset and frustrated about the lying and the corporate corruption in the United States. I mean, you can look at the Trump campaign and see that there's a lot of people, it's a populist right movement in many ways. A lot of the Tea Party people are behind Trump. There's a lot of upset.
No doubt. If gun freedom is your number one freedom, then you'd have to re-rank those numbers, right, if that was the only thing that mattered. But these guys took in a lot of different factors. I recommend you take a closer look. I posted on our Facebook page and Twitter. You can just go to news.freetalklive.com and link over to either one of those. And then you can dig through over 100 pages of data and figure out how they put this together. Thanks, Aaron, for your call. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
The Ashley Madison lawsuit. This is the first. I imagine there may be more. There's already one that is in the works, a class action suit being filed in Canada over Ashley Madison, the website that was promising affairs, guaranteed affairs, for those who are willing to pay $250 per month. And now the data is out. The hack team that put it out there is... called Impact Team. The story over at Vice.com will tell us more. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
You can share your thoughts with us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And don't forget, if you want to help Free Talk Live, one of the ways to do it is to share the show. If you like what we're doing on this program, then you know, share the fact that you're listening on your favorite social media. Share a link to your most recent favorite episode, which, of course, you can download anytime you want over at freetalklive.com. And, you know, share in appropriate places. Don't spam. Just share every now and then something that you thought was cool. And we appreciate that. That's a big thing that you can do, and it costs you nothing but just a moment. So once again, whether it's Twitter, Facebook, or whatever, just drop your favorite show link in there, and it should just automatically come right up with a player and everything. So thank you in advance for doing that. Numerous former users of AshleyMadison.com have approached multiple law firms to inquire about their privacy rights under Canadian law, says one of the law firm's lawyers in a statement. They are outraged that AshleyMadison.com failed to protect its users' information. In many cases, the users paid an additional fee for the website to remove all of their user data, only to discover that the information was left intact and exposed. Now, when you are asked to pay a site money to remove your account, you know you're dealing with a really shifty kind of business here. Right, because this reminds me of the remember the what do they call them, revenge porn sites. Remember there was the one guy who was doing a revenge porn site. He did the same thing where he would sort of similar, I guess. With the revenge porn site, people who were not the women in the pictures would put their pictures online, and then the women in the pictures would find their pictures on the revenge porn
site. Dear God, take this down.
They would demand the site take it down, and then the guy running the site would charge them for the service of taking down their photo. This seems very similar to me. The idea that, oh, well, I've given you all this data. I've entered into a contract with you. And now you're going to charge me an exit fee. I mean, it's a legit thing to do. Certainly cell phone companies do that kind of thing. They charge you if you want to cancel their contract. But it just, to me, that rings of real shifty behavior, charging someone to delete their information, which ultimately they didn't do. And I would say that is... it sounds like an actionable item from a lawsuit perspective. Lawyer Ted Charney told Vice News that roughly 100 people have expressed interest in joining this lawsuit, although only Mr. Shore, who says he never met anyone in person from the website, has agreed to be named. Charney says this is the sort of case where the violation is so egregious that everyone wants to join, though they don't want to be outed.
Yep.
He says that anyone who registers with the class action, which is limited to Canadian customers, will remain anonymous. The attorney says that Impact Team has not been sued. Well, duh. How are you going to sue a hack group? That's like suing Anonymous. You can't do that.
I'm surprised. No, I haven't heard the word Anonymous bandied about with this hacking group. But I'm, you know, to some extent, they're taking a, if not a moral stance, at the very least, a sanctimonious stance.
The Impact Team?
Whatever the hacking group is. Yeah. I haven't heard that word either.
I've said it a few times. Impact
okay.
Team.
Okay. Yeah. I guess it just doesn't stick out in my mind.
Doesn't have impact, apparently.
Apparently not. Yeah. And, you know, they're all saying, oh, you're a bunch of cheaters. And, you know, it to me, what it looks like is a bunch, you know, some guys that got cheated on or something. I don't know.
What do you mean? Oh, the Impact
Team?
Yeah. That would be pretty cool if it was like an all-female hack team.
You don't hear about that too often. It sounds like Hollywood.
So anyway, on Thursday, cybersecurity company investigating the Ashley Madison hack told the Canadian press that the massive data breach can't be used to prove the infidelity of its customers, noting that it doesn't check email addresses in order to ensure that no account can be conclusively linked with a specific person. Ah, and that is what I had first heard about this. And apparently that's true, that you know, normally when you go to a website and you sign up for something, there's an email verification. And this is just good web standards, right? The reason for an email verification is to make sure that someone can't just take mark@freetalklive.com and sign him up for a website. But if someone wanted to do that, they could do that at Ashley Madison because there's no email verification. And that's, of course, where you get the email from the site. You open the link, and there's a link in there, and it says, click this to verify your account name. That verifies that you had actually gone to their website to sign up. If there is no email verification, then anyone can do that. So that's the point they're making here, is that just because someone's email address shows up on Ashley Madison's leaked database doesn't necessarily mean that person was the person who used their email to sign up for the site. So, for instance, BarackObama@WhiteHouse.com and several
likely signed up, right?
Several misspellings of BarackObama@WhiteHouse.com are signed up in this database, right? So anybody just put those in there.
Likely Barack, if he wants to cheat, doesn't need to do it that
way. Through this website.
Yeah, so it also sort of brings up, what is the level of cheating? Is it signing up for the website? Is it going to take a look?
Yeah.
Cheating is, you know, I mean,
doing the act, obviously, is cheating.
There's some level of, right, we certainly have that. There's some, but there's all kinds of steps in between on this website, between doing nothing and having sex with some hooker from Ashley Madison.
Some people will say that even looking at another person of the opposite sex or whatever is cheating. Cheating with your eyes.
Well, you're going to have a heck of a time. Just about every website out there has got some personals ad running up there. And you know what? They're all hot and they're all in your area. And, I mean, you know, that's obviously a bunch of hooey.
But there are people who you know, would be upset that their spouse was, you know, even sending messages on the Ashley Madison site.
Are those the people that have the shared Facebook account where it's like Jim and Susie and then Smith? Have you seen those Facebook accounts?
Yeah, I guess.
Is that group? That's that couple?
I don't know.
That they're always suspicious of each other? I don't know. That's what I always think. I wonder who's been naughty.
Let's see here. There's a little more. The company also said Ashley Madison does not collect phone numbers or store full credit card numbers. This company, whoever they are, this company that is telling this to the Canadian press, they're kind of whitewashing this because... Yeah, it's true they may not have collected phone numbers or storing full credit card numbers, and that's good for people's credit card safety. But the credit card information is still on file. I had a guy looking through this data. A friend of mine was looking through this data last night. He downloaded it on his own volition. You can get it from, I think the Pirate Bay has it now. So you can just download it via a torrent. And he found people in this area's credit card information in there. Now, maybe he didn't find their numbers, but he did find the name on the credit card that was run and how often the charge was run. There's some guy in New Hampshire who spent $250 a month on his credit card at Ashley Madison. So in that guy's case...
So every single month kind of thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was getting some service or another.
He was getting something. So, you know, if you look at that, not only does that show that he's getting some kind of service, but it also shows that... The claim that, oh, well, that wasn't me. I didn't sign that up. I didn't sign for that account. They weren't verifying email, so you can't prove that it was me. Well, yeah, okay, we can prove that it was you because here's your credit card. So whoever signed up with your email, okay, fine. You can't prove that. But you can prove that someone used your credit card on Ashley Madison.
It looks like somebody signed up for Ashley Madison and used your credit card, sir. Over and over again.
So yeah, so some people, so within this database, this 10 gigs, there are going to be some people who just signed up and they didn't do anything, right? So there's going to be a lot of those people. They just signed up, they joined the site, but they never actually paid for it. Those people have plausible deniability. But for all of the people who actually paid Ashley Madison, and of course a lot of them were trying to pay to respond to these robots, these alleged robots that the site had sending out emails to people to try to entice them to buy the $20 package.
Right, you've got a message from this imaginary person.
All of those people are in serious jeopardy of having their information revealed publicly. And the more public the person is, the more damning and bad that's going to look for them. So I would expect within the next couple weeks, maybe even sooner than that, you're going to start to see some real dirty stuff.
Does it matter to you if you know, some presidential candidate's on this? Does it matter to you if some state level politician?
If there's a presidential candidate that's on this, I will totally use that when they come to Keene and confront them with it.
I suspect if there's a presidential candidate on that, that's
we would have heard about it by now.
And maybe.
That's got to be one of the first things people are searching for, is all of the presidential candidates on this database. Somebody must have done that search already.
Yeah, I don't know. This is one of these things that the demographic, the psychographic that'll run for office, especially the highest office in the land, is the kind of psychographic that thinks they can get away with anything. Mm-hmm. They're, in many cases, you know, sociopathic in many ways, and that person's going to say, not only should I be able to enjoy the benefits of married life, but I should be able to cheat too. And yeah, there's a good way to do it.
You know, I think we could talk more about this. Glenn Greenwald has an interesting opinion that maybe we'll discuss on the Sunday edition of the show. His story about this is called The Puritanical Glee Over the Ashley Madison Hack. So sort of coming at it from a different perspective. So we'll join you for the live Sunday show. You can join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Enjoy your weekend.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Mike Stenerson from Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
The Mike Siegel Show on the Future of Talk Radio, GCN.
Here, Live United. Go to Live.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. Good news for the Caribbean. Danny's weakening and is no longer classified as a hurricane.
Danny has weakened to a tropical storm and now has maximum sustained winds of 65 miles per hour. It's moving into an area of very hostile upper-level winds, and that's what's causing the weakening.
Forecaster Robbie Berg says Danny could bring some much-needed rain to some of the islands in the Caribbean.
We could see 2 to 4 inches of rain in some of the islands, which they actually need that rain. They're in a drought right now. So if we can keep the winds low but get them some rain, that actually would be a good thing.
Also at SRNnews.com, firefighters continue to battle a massive wildfire in Washington State's Okanagan County. Homeowner Brad Craig says he's been worried about his house.
They told us to evacuate 3 days ago, and we spent the first night, or I spent the first night here, just kind of watching the place, and then the next day, my wife talked me into leaving, but I've been coming over several times a day checking on it.
The fire is burning a 355-square-mile area and is the largest fire in Washington state. At the Defending the American Dream Summit in Columbus, Ohio, Saturday, GOP Senator and presidential hopeful Marco Rubio told an enthusiastic crowd there needs to be fewer regulations to help the U.S. become more competitive with other countries.
The first thing that we must do is become globally competitive again. That's why we talk about tax reform. That's why we talk about regulatory reform.
Also appearing on stage were Rick Perry and Ted Cruz. Jeb Bush and Bobby Jindal appeared on Friday. Plunging oil prices are giving travelers a bit of a break at the pump this summer as the driving season starts to wind down. GasBuddy.com puts the average price of a gallon of regular gas at $2.61 a gallon nationwide. That's down by more than 80 cents of what we were paying about a year ago this time. This is SRN News.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360 to talk to a certified counselor.
I had heard about Trinity, so I made the call. They took care of all of my credit cards, and now I am completely debt-free.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360.
My name is Anne, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-758-5360.
New evidence shows the EPA had advanced warning that its work at a played-out gold mine near Silverton, Colorado, was a disaster waiting to happen. SRN's Bob Agnew has more.
Internal documents released by the EPA show that officials were aware of the potential for a catastrophic blowout at an abandoned mine that could release large volumes of wastewater laced with toxic heavy metals. And that's exactly what happened. EPA and contract workers accidentally unleashed 3 million gallons of contaminated wastewater August 5th. There are now at least three ongoing investigations into exactly what happened as that disaster tainted rivers in three western states. Bob Agnew, SRN News.
Two Citigroup affiliates have agreed to pay $179.5 million to resolve federal regulators' charges of misleading investors and hedge funds that later collapsed. Both neither denied any wrongdoing, but did agree to refrain from future violations of security laws. This is SRN News. An indoor gun range slash restaurant slash bar in Florida.
Daytona Beach is about to get its first indoor shooting range connected to a restaurant that sells alcohol. City commissioners approved a measure that will allow a 12-lane gun range and restaurant. Obvious concerns addressed by developers. If a restaurant customer orders an alcoholic beverage, their driver's license will be scanned along with everyone at the table. If the person drinking wanted to then go to the range, their license will be scanned again and the customer will be flagged as someone blocked from shooting. The range will also offer a place for law enforcement to train with a simulator, which will add another layer of safety. Val Dior, SRN News.
The head of sailing's governing body threatening to move all Olympic events out of Brazil's polluted Guanabara Bay and into the open Atlantic unless the water is cleaned up and removed before next year's Rio Games. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
It's so lonely here. I can barely stand it. I'm waiting for you to stroke your keys and unload over at gcnlive.com/community. Oh, come on. I know you have things to share. And there's a whole place waiting for you to share them. Light some candles, pour yourself a drink, and get cozy. Log in at gcnlive.com/community. Lots of people are satisfied. Why not satisfy yourself at gcnlive.com/community? I'm waiting. Get out of the friend zone at delicious.com.
Welcome to the Tech Night Owl Live, the show for PC users who can handle the truth. And now, here's your host,
Gene Steinberg.
On the Tech Night Out Live this week, we'll be featuring Adam Inks of Tidbits and Take Control Books. And a little bit later, we'll hear from our old friend Jeff Gamet of the Mac Observer. So together, it's going to make a great show, the Tech Night Out Live. So before we started our conversation with Adam Inks, he was busy consuming his lunch. He was wolfing it down. And my response was, forget about that. I do a bad imitation of that. My favorite werewolf sound comes from the Warren Zevon recording, Werewolves of London, which I think he kind of made up as he did the song. It sounds that way.
You never know. I will say, who knew that wolves liked leftover pizza so much?
Is that it? What kind of pizza?
Let me think.
Just ate the pizza he forgot.
Well, see, it's the pizza I made, so I had to think about it. So it was mushroom, onion, and pepperoni. Very tasty.
Mushroom, onion, pepperoni.
And pepperoni.
Does wonders to your breath.
Well, that's what we're using Skype for.
You see, I don't have to smell it. I just have to listen. Yeah, I'll have a meatball pizza. Mm. I'll have a sausage pizza. I'll have a cheese pizza.
That's the problem. When you're making your own pizza, you make the kind of pizza that you got the stuff in the fridge for.
Do you make it from scratch or you buy something that you warm up?
Yeah, make it from scratch.
You're kidding.
No, that's what bread makers are for. They make pizza dough really well.
Ah, but you don't have the same kind of oven they have in a pizza restaurant, though.
No, we have a pizza stone, which does pretty well, but we do not have a full-bore pizza oven, it's true.
So is there a picture out there on YouTube of you tossing the pie?
No, and actually, it turns out a lot of people really don't do that. I mean, I can do it. I have done it in the past, but a rolling pin actually works a lot better.
So when you see people do that, that's just a shtick.
It's a bit of a show, yeah. No, I think that when you're doing it, producing them in bulk at a pizzeria, you probably, and particularly behind the scenes, you probably just roll them out fast.
So will there be a Take Control book on how to make pizza?
Probably not, given that our Thanksgiving dinner book was not a huge bestseller.
That's kind of sad. Not that we'd ever make a Thanksgiving dinner. I think that goes back a generation or two with a lot of families. I think a lot of people, you know, have traditions like that, but more and more people don't have the time. They go to a restaurant, like the local Boston Market, not so local, it's a 20-minute drive away. They make a perfectly serviceable and affordable Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, we sort of ran into with that book that we think is that our audience tends to be, well, frankly, adults. People who either have not going to cook Thanksgiving dinner because they've done it before and don't need to do it again, or they are going to cook it and they know exactly what they do. So the kind of the target market for that kind of book would be younger people who are doing their first Thanksgiving dinner and are really at sea. They have to do it, they want to do it, but they at best have watched before. And
they don't have like a parent or something to bring in there or some crazy uncle to show them how to do it.
Well, the problem is Thanksgiving dinner is the sort of thing you got to start well in advance. So even if you do have a relative coming over that day to help, that's too late. If you didn't know to defrost the turkey for like 3 or 4 days beforehand, your turkey is frozen solid.
Okay, so basically you have to have the parents stay for a few days. So if you have a problem with the mother or the mother-in-law or something like that, give it up.
There are other problems. As I said, it was a great book, a truly fabulous book, and it still is. Thanksgiving dinner does not change. But it is one of those books which did not prove to be one of our top sellers.